recommend watching these videos before viewing this one. ServiceNow Knowledge Management version 3 in Fuji is significantly different from KM version 2 in Eureka. When upgrading from Eureka or an earlier release to Fuji, you'll need to migrate legacy knowledge articles and any customizations you've made in order to use the full range of new functionality shown here. Starting with Fuji patch 10, more migration tasks are automated than in previous Fuji patches. If your instance started out on Fuji or a later release, that is, you didn't upgrade from Eureka or earlier, this video doesn't apply to you. This video covers what happens to KM version 2 content upon upgrade and the steps necessary to fully migrate knowledge following upgrade. Click an item to go directly to that topic, or continue watching to cover all topics. The product documentation covers the differences between knowledge management versions 2 and 3. Upgrading automatically implements some required changes, which you should review. Other changes must be completed manually to take full advantage of the KM version 3 features. These are covered here in the product documentation, and we'll demonstrate them shortly. Here's our instance after upgrading from Eureka to Fuji patch 11. The legacy knowledge modules are still here. For this demo, we've added a few of the KM version 3 modules to the application navigator. Later, we'll show you how to add version 3 modules and remove version 2 modules. The Knowledge Application menu is available by default to users with the Knowledge role, but we've changed that to Admin because we don't want others using the Knowledge Application until the migration is complete. You can restrict access to whatever roles make sense in your organization. The Knowledge Bases module is new in KM version 3. It lists all knowledge bases in the instance. Upon upgrade, all legacy knowledge articles are placed in the Knowledge KB, which is classified as version 2. We'll add this field to the list so that we can see the versions. Any new knowledge bases added after upgrade are created as version 3. Here, we've added a version 3 KB policies, which contains no articles yet. In version 3 KBs, the can read and can contribute lists are used to control access based on user criteria. We can't add user criteria to a version 2 KB because the can read and can contribute lists aren't available. All content from this KB should be migrated to a version 3 KB. Here's one of our legacy knowledge articles. We're going to migrate it and all the policy articles to the version 3 policies KB. The knowledge base field is mandatory in KM version 3. If you upgraded to Fuji patch 10 or higher as we did, the knowledge base field appears on the article form. However, if you upgraded to a lower Fuji patch or your knowledge article form was customized in KM version 2, you must add the knowledge base field to the form to be able to create new articles. In KM version 2, articles were organized by topic and category, which are replaced by configurable category hierarchy in version 3. If you upgraded to Fuji patch 10 or higher, the topic and category from version 2 are automatically converted to levels 1 and 2 of the version 3 category hierarchy. If you upgraded to a Fuji patch below 10, you must convert these manually by creating a category hierarchy and then assigning the category for each article. See the product documentation for details. In KM version 3, by default, the system displays user feedback about KB articles on live feed. System administrators can change this on the Knowledge Management Properties page. The Knowledge KB functions as a version 2 knowledge base, providing users continued access to legacy content while you migrate articles to version 3 knowledge bases at your own pace. Users with the necessary access can still create new articles and edit articles in the legacy Knowledge KB. This KM version 3 homepage, $knowledge.do, was created during upgrade. The legacy articles are available here in the Knowledge KB. This homepage relies on AngularJS technology, which requires Chrome, Firefox, or Internet Explorer 10 or higher. The system redirects users with unsupported browsers to the legacy portal. If you customized your knowledge base in KM version 2 before upgrading, you can still view the legacy portal KB Home after upgrading through the View module. Customizations to the KM version 2 legacy portal aren't migrated to version 3, so custom layout, links, and the advanced search feature aren't available after upgrade. Finally, customizations made to ACL rules on the knowledge table in KM version 2 may result in unexpected behavior when users browse or search for articles after upgrade. For example, they may see an article listed in search results, but be unable to view it. This is because in KM version 3, the search function operates on user criteria for all knowledge bases, whether they're version 2, like this one, or version 3. If you customized ACL rules on the knowledge table in KM version 2, see this video for more information after viewing the simple migration shown here. We need to migrate all these articles from the legacy knowledge base to new KB version 3 knowledge bases. We'll start with policies. We've already created a new KB for these articles, following the procedure shown in this video. The main focus of most migration efforts is access control, because legacy functionality used roles and ACL rules to control access at the article level. And KM version 3 uses user criteria at the KB level. We've set up our user criteria and used them to specify who has can contribute rights, as shown in this video. The example shown here doesn't require migrating ACL rules from KM version 2. For an example involving more complex access controls, see this video. The next step is to migrate knowledge functionality, which involves replacing modules, creating publish and retire workflows, and migrating knowledge content. We'll come back to replacing modules shortly. The system provides several default workflows, which you can use as is or copy to create new ones. Workflow design is beyond the scope of this video. We'll just use the default workflows. Defining category structures is covered in this video. And we've already defined categories and subcategories for our policies KB. So now let's move all of our policy articles to the policies KB by changing their knowledge base value and assigning categories to them. Eventually, we need to move all these articles to new KM version 3 knowledge bases. But for now, we'll focus on these 19 policies. We can migrate articles one at a time by opening each and selecting the knowledge base and category. Or we can use the list editor to assign the knowledge base to multiple articles at the same time. To do this, first we must change the default list edit type to save immediately cell edit mode. If you don't want to keep this setting for list editing, remember to change it back when you're done migrating your KB content. Now we add the knowledge base field to the list and filter the list to include only the articles we want to move to the policies KB. Select the cells we want to change and edit them. Now, all 19 of our articles are in the KM version 3 policies KB. We still have to go into each article to assign the KM version 3 category. Alternatively, you can use a script, as described in this KB article on high, to change the knowledge base and set the version 3 category on multiple articles at the same time. After all content is migrated from the KM version 2 knowledge KB, we can deactivate it. Also, it's a good practice to test the KM version 3 knowledge bases to make sure they're functioning as expected. Now there's just one more thing to do. Replace the KM version 2 modules in the knowledge application with the version 3 modules. If you're on Fuji patch 11 or higher, you could use this backup script to replace the modules, but we'll show how to do it manually, following these tables to deactivate the legacy modules and activate the Knowledge V3 modules. System administrators can do this through the System Definition Application Menus module. Let's keep the tables from the product documentation handy as we change these. A quick way to do it is to select the checkboxes for all items whose active state we want to change from true to false, or vice versa, and then change the whole batch here. We'll select them all and then clear the checkboxes for the few items we don't want to change. For example, the KM version 3 modules we already activated, homepage, all, knowledge bases, properties, and user criteria, and some that we don't need. Now that we've completed our migration, we'll remove our admin role restriction from the knowledge application and restore the default role of knowledge. Our knowledge application lists only KM version 3 modules, and the legacy knowledge KB is gone, and all the version 3 features are functional. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.